Introducing the world's first warm-blooded fish. Whoa! The moonfish, Lampris catautus, is the first known warm-blooded fish. It swims in the deep, dark waters of the Pacific Ocean off the coast of California, sometimes plunging to murky depths 1,300 feet below the surface. As it makes its way through the sea, though, the moonfish is blissfully unaware that a sophisticated satellite tracking system is monitoring its every movement. The moonfish can produce internal heat by moving its pectoral fins. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Association researchers are among those who have been monitoring the moonfish, also known as the OPA, in this way in an effort to learn more about it. However, the scientists leading a study of this somewhat mysterious deep-sea dweller, which is more or less equivalent in size to a car tire and can weigh up to nearly 200 pounds, were perhaps not thoroughly prepared for the startling, unprecedented discovery that they were about to make. The NOAA research suggests that the moonfish's warm-blooded system gives it a strong advantage over other deep-sea predators. Biologist Nicholas Wegner of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Association's Southwest Fisheries Science Center in La Jolla, California, and Owen Snodgrass, who works for the National Marine Fisheries Services in San Diego, were among those who undertook a new comprehensive study of the sizable pelagic fish. And it was during the team's investigation into this creature, in fact, that Wegner noticed something highly odd about it. Examining a sample of moonfish gill tissue that had been collected by Snodgrass, Wegner found something truly extraordinary. Twisted around the fish's cold blood-bearing vessels, which push cold blood into its main body after it draws up oxygen from the water, was a set of vessels ferrying warm blood to the moonfish's gills. This blood vessel system is, in engineering terms, a countercurrent heat exchange and is somewhat reminiscent of the mechanics of a car radiator. Moreover, the discovery of this immediately suggested that the moonfish can boast of a unique warm blood circulating technique, making it the first completely warm-blooded fish ever identified. The discovery of the warm-blooded system utilized by the moonfish was a marine science milestone. There had never been anything like this in a fish's gills before, explained Wegner. This is a cool innovation. That gives them a competitive edge, he added. The concept of countercurrent heat exchange was invented in fish long before we thought of it. This incredible evolutionary advantage enables the moonfish to maintain a raised body temperature even in the bitterly cold, dark depths of the ocean it inhabits. And this goes a long way toward explaining both why it's such a successful predator and how it can dwell so far from the surface of the sea. Typically, deep-sea fish are slow, energy-saving creatures that don't actively hunt or chase their prey. Instead, they're usually reduced to taking their oblivious food sources by surprise. The moonfish, however, has been found to be a slightly different type of deep-ocean dweller. By contrast, the moonfish is a fast-moving, aggressive predator, gliding through deep waters at speeds by continuously and quickly flapping its colorful pectoral fins. This movement helps in turn to heat up and maintain the warmth of its body core and to increase its metabolic rate. Even Wegner was surprised to discover the moonfish's atypical proactive deep water hunting instincts, as he'd assumed that the creature would be like the majority of other fish that dwell in the depths. Because it can warm its body, it turns out to be a very active predator that chases down agile prey like squid and can migrate long distances, he's explained. Indeed, the groundbreaking research of Wegner's team suggests that the moonfish's ability to keep its flattened, oval-shaped body warm in very low temperatures greatly enhances its ability to successfully attack prey. And its eyesight and reaction time are additionally both better than those of its cold-blooded counterparts. So, how did scientists learn so much more about the poorly understood moonfish's internal workings than was previously known? Well, backed by the Southwest Fisheries Science Center, the inquisitive biologist used a variety of different techniques, technologies, equipment, and experiments to acquire the game-changing data and information. First, the researchers had to catch some test subjects, which they did during expeditions off the coast of California. Having snared and studied some of the eye-catching fish, the scientists then went on to fix monitors to them in order to acquire temperature information on the creatures. And the work led to some very interesting findings. Using the information they collected, the team soon discovered that the body temperatures of the moonfish stayed virtually constant, even when the creatures dove deeper into much cooler waters, hundreds of feet below the surface. In fact, they found out that the fish's muscle temperatures, on average, regularly measured around 41 degrees Fahrenheit higher than the warmth of the encompassing ocean water. The findings illustrate why the moonfish is able to stay in the cold depths for a long time without swimming in the direction of the surface. And this is a distinct competitive advantage, as rival fish capable of heating parts of their bodies temporarily through movement, like tuna and certain species of shark, still have to swim toward the surface to warm up or risk organ failure and depth. Aside from having this evolutionary and revolutionary warm-blooded system that gives it an edge over other deep-sea fish, the OPA still keeps warm thanks to an abundance of fatty tissue around vital features like its gills and heart, not to mention its muscle tissue. This in turn protects it from the cold water. Fascinatingly, the research has in addition highlighted clear disparities between different types of OPA from various oceans and seas around the globe, for this is a fish that's found in both tropical and moderate temperature waters. And the genealogy of the particular moonfish in question here suggests that it gradually developed the warm-blooded mechanism that gives it such an advantage. Furthermore, following the amazing discovery from Wegner's team, researchers are now looking at comparing the blood-heating mechanisms in the various fish. Even as a seasoned biologist, Wegner is constantly amazed by the natural world and the ability of its inhabitants to constantly adapt and evolve, as so brilliantly illustrated by the moonfish. "Nature has a way of surprising us with clever strategies where you'd least expect them," he said. "It's hard to stay warm when you're surrounded by cold water, but the OPA has figured it out." Another interesting phenomenon regarding the moonfish is that more and more of them are being caught in investigative NOAA surveys. Wegner and other biologists are not completely certain as to why this is happening. Two theories are that either there are more favorable ocean conditions for the fish, or they're growing in number. What is certain, though, is that the team's landmark study, which was published in Science magazine, is a triumph for scientific inquiry. Francisco Werner, Science and Research Director of the Southwest Fisheries Science Center, praised the groundbreaking research. "Discoveries like this help us understand the role species play in the marine ecosystems and why we find them where we do," he said. "It really demonstrates how much we learn from basic research out on the water, thanks to curious scientists asking good questions about why this fish appeared to be different."